Next paper will be presented by Ludwig Stratil. Paper is entitled Experiments in Modeling of Ductile Fracture Behavior and Fracture Toughness of Low Alloy Carbon Manganese Steel.
Thank you for the introduction. So my work is about ductile fracture behavior of low alloy steel. First, short introduction how that work been, let's say, designed and why we are doing that. I received the project for international cooperation within my Institute of Czech Academy of Science. And I was willing to propose whatever institute where would I work on my topic, which is basically fracture toughness and small specimen size effect on it. Because one of my colleagues, Filip Šiška, did a postdoc at Centre de Matériaux in Évry. He recommended me this institute to apply for and ask. And at the end, we agreed together with Jacques Besson, who is also here, set up the research at the States with an internship at CBM. I would also like to thanks for cooperation with Jazit Marie, who is also from this Institute of Centre de Matériaux, and moreover is also working or teaching us at EPF. And maybe some of you know my supervisor at my Institute of Physics of Materials, Ivo Dlouhý. So let's go to the outline of the presentation. First, I will briefly will let you inform about background, about fracture toughness and size effect. Then I will go on to the experiments and then to results, discussion and comparison of validity limits and to the conclusion. So what is the motivation? What is the motivation for using small specimen size, which can be conflicting in a quite demanding fracture toughness standards and measurement? So the motivation is quite either you don't have enough test material, it can be naturally done, for example, by tin construction. The next, which is also quite important, is laboratory scale research, because fracture toughness naturally is very demanding from the point of view of test material, and simply that you are performing some development of the new alloys with usually limited amount of the material, so you always questioning what evaluation of the material properties is like. The next important issue that with small specimen size, you can easily monitor degradation level of the components if there is some aging, or in case of some catastrophic failure, you can more easily determine the cause of that damage. And also one of the applications is testing of irradiated materials, which is naturally realized in small amount in order to not have so much difficulty with the amount of the material which is irradiated, because it is very easy for waste disposal. The next question we try to point out with Jacques and Jazit Marie is the application of miniature specimen to very ductile materials, how it will look like. So, and which type of the specimens we are using or we've been aimed in this work are the standard geometry specimen which been converted from international well-known standard for example, STMe 1820 or ISO 12135. So basically, the most used are frequent band specimens or CT specimens. Here you can see such scaling go down. That scaling means that really all dimensions are scaled down in order to provide the same geometry configuration within this cross section and the mode of the loading. So here on this image you can see standard 1D specimen from 3-point bending, which is very well known. It's a Sharpie geometry with cross section 10x10.25, which is used either for Sharpie testing or with pre-crack also for fracture toughness measurement. And there is that very small cavity specimen, which cross-section 3x4mm, which is used for surveillance programs from the broader house of standard Sharpie specimens. From these specimens, some guys also creating very small CT specimens. For example, there is a reference of Civetta from Mol in Belgium. So, like for any fracture toughness test, also this small size requires this necessity, which always relies in the way of interpretation of behavior via which you measure the material properties and discussion of the results obtained. And when you have this, you can answer the second very important question: is what is the correlation of the results with other specimen size, and if there is some size effect, there is need of its correction. Naturally, because of very complex state of the constraint at the crack tip, you are always questioning the stress strain via material behavior and specimen geometry within the specimen. So briefly, we can illustrate the situation like here, which is normalized stress in front of the crack tip. This via this normalization parameter, which was introduced by DOS, it's done as the distance and of the crack tip times EL strength divided J integral as the parameter of the loading of the specimen. So there is normalized distance ahead of the crack tip. This shadow line corresponds to the boundary layer metal conditions because of like very well constrained, or it can be said that this is the stress state at the crack tip in the standard specimen. When you are decreasing down all the dimensions of the specimen, like this in the direction of the Sharpie and Kalesti specimen, you are seeing that there is the tendency that the stress state in front of the crack tip in larger distance is decreasing, and this is well known phenomenon known as the loss of constraint. We can see that this loss of constraint is substantial for Sharpie geometry and even more substantial for geometry which is scaled one time more from this Sharpie. Of course, to measure fracture toughness, you can either be in the ductile to brittle transition region, which is very significant for BCC metal. In case of SCC metal, you don't face this, you have just upper shelf energy. So, I was dealing in this work with R-curve. So, R-curve is fracture toughness characteristic at upper shelf energy region, and it's dependence of the J-integral crack length increment. Let me show you some results I done in last year. These results were presented on the conference Pressure Vessel Piping on Hawaii in 2017. And in this work, we've been testing in terms of R-curve three size of CT specimen, which have been scaled down exactly in the same way as 3-point band specimens. So here you can see load displacement curve of 1D specimen, half D CT specimen, and water size CT specimen. these results are done at room temperature, so here you can see the evaluated R curves. And there is one interesting point, because the smallest specimen water T is in a substantial part of JR curve above J limit. It has provisional value of J integral about 400, and as we see the evaluation of the validity limits, it doesn't meet the validity limits. The other two specimens, size 0.5T and 1T, has quite similar R curve, and both these curves are well within either 0.T is within the validity limit, and 1T validity limit is not shown in this picture because it's much larger than 1,200 kilojoules per square meter. So in these two cases, the size which you have to fully fight for valid fracture toughness measurement is pretty well confirmed, because the smallest size, in, for example, in half the CT specimens is 7 millimeters, and the smallest dimensions in this specimen you have always, we start that geometry 12.5 millimeters. So it means that once you have inside the validity limits, the R curve is not dependent on the geometry and the size, and thus it's valid. So let's go on to the experiments done within this work. Our test material is pipeline steel of this grade. In simple way, it's the steel type X65 from producer Tenalis Dalman, Italian producer, and this material comes from the seamless pipe with external diameter 344 millimeters and thickness 29 millimeters, so we've been able to machine even 1T CT specimens. Application of the material is in the offshore pipelines for petroleum industry, and this material is very high ductile and has high fracture toughness. We did the characterization again as for P91 steel on previous slide at room temperature. We did the testing of smooch and notch tensile bar in order to determine material properties in tensions. We also test Sharpe properties via standard Sharpe test specimen and mini Sharpe specimens. And fracture toughness testing was done according to the standard ASTM E1820 on three specimen size. But it's exactly the same specimen size as I present on the slide before. The only difference was this in this case, because of high ductility of the material, we did not pre-cracking the crack. So we introduced the crack via EDM as a very sharp notch with the radius 0.1 millimeter. So let's see what's its microstructure of this material. This is alloyed steel. This steel is, that's why, quite cheap. It can be used for high amount of the production in order to machine pipelines in the cheap way. That's why there is also this heat treatment process, which consists from austenitization, quenching and tempering. That's why this material after quenching and tempering is normalized, and it has no anisotropy effect, which is also suitable for our study, because we don't have to deal with the anisotropy. Hardness of the material is 210 HB. So within tensile properties, we did the testing of smooth and notch tensile bars with the radius 1.2, 2.4 and 6.0 millimeters, which are marked at NT2, NT4 and NT10. Here you can see the diagram, which is the stress over reduction of diameter. This reduction of diameter was measured by optical wave. The material has rather low tensile strength properties, but very good ductility. So there are the Sharpie properties. Thanks to large ductility, we had to measure the Sharpie test on standard specimen with additional load on 450 joules. So here is the curve from the standard specimen. So it has very low upper shelf level, which is about 320 joules, and ductile to liter temperature is -108 degrees. Size comparison with mini Sharpie specimens of dimensions 3x4 on 15 joules Hever looks like this. The upper shelf energy is about 10 joules, and DBTT temperature is -162. So we have an approximate shift of DBTT 54 degrees. Here is the description of the fracture toughness testing. So you see all three sizes of the specimens. The specimens being sized 10 by 10% in order to have the best ratio for the geometric configuration. J-integral requires load line displacement measurement. So that's why in that smallest geometry, because of size limitation, we had to measure the front face displacement, and then we intercalculate the load line displacement using this ratio chip. So we have the loads for the water size 0.5 and 1 kg specimens. You can see that the ductility of the material is very high, because approximate maximum is about 1.5 millimeters for water size. For half T is about 3, and for standard 1T specimen is about 5. So there is the normalized load displacement curve, and we can see this tendency that standard size specimens show the deformation in the level about 0.1, and decreasing specimen size, you are shifting the maximum load thanks to early deformation. It means that this deformation are not confirmed the fracture behavior of the material properly. So here there are the evaluating JR curves. The validity limits for each size are here by the window, and you can see that neither of size is properly spaced within validity window. That's why we can see high size effect on JQ values, and just very tightly on this specimen fully filed the validity limits. Here is the comparison between these two steels. Let's go to the proper evaluation. We can see that our test steel has much lower strength properties than steel T91, and thanks to this, and thanks to much higher fracture toughness properties in steel X65, only 1T specimen been valid, and other small size been invalid. And for P91 steel, both size 1T and half T was valid, and water size was not invalid. So we can see that the fracture toughness is always a question of the material properties and the necessity size for its validation. Here is the fractography of fracture toughness specimen surfaces. So we can see huge blunting, which is marked by the red color. And there is the example of the very high ductility micromechanism. Our aim is to predict this size effect via GTM model of damage. And so here you can see just preliminary results. So it's the same question, the same picture as I showed it for you for notch bar specimens, but there are moreover the results of preliminary simulation, which are marked by the red color. So you see that it works pretty well, and we will of course use this model for correction of the size effect on the material. So let's go to the conclusion. So the our material exhibit very high fracture toughness. It means that upper shelf energy test has about 320 joules. There is significant size effect between three specimen size, and the only large specimen size 1T meets the validity limit. Based on this, we can conclude that within validity limits, the specimen size doesn't show any size effect on fracture toughness. So thank you for your attention.